Principle number four in Outlasting the Gay Revolution, refuse to redefine marriage. Listen, for all practical purposes, with the Dred Scott decision, when that came down 5-4 from the Supreme Court, Abraham Lincoln ignored it. Just because the court rules a certain way doesn't mean we have to accept it. Roe v. Wade. What happened? That galvanized the pro-life movement in 1973. The court may have ruled that women have a right to abortion. We don't recognize it as a right. We're going to stand up for that baby. We're going to stand up for that mother. We're going to say there is a better way. Maybe you are a county clerk. Maybe you're an educator. Maybe you're a pastor. Just because the Supreme Court made an outrageous ruling doesn't mean that we have to accept it. We refuse to redefine it. And it's not because we're hateful. It's because we love what's best. Once you redefine marriage, you render it meaningless. Once you say it's not the unique union of one man and one woman together for life, it could become anything. It could be two or three or five or one. You have no limit on it. Once you say marriage equality for all, you open the door wide. In fact, one of the most shocking things I demonstrate in Outlasting the Gay Revolution is there's even a celebration now of incest in the media. This is now the in cool thing. I was asked to be part of an online debate by a very liberal pro-gay website, and it was about adult consensual incest. Should it be legal? They interviewed five different people. I was the only one out of the five that said it should not be legal. We refuse to redefine marriage because we do not want it to go where it should not go. We're going to be loving towards all people, kind towards all people, but we're not going to call it marriage.